I'll be there in a sec.
This is London Calling. You're listening to me, Tash, on Bucket In, your source for what they don't want you to know. This time we're turning our focus back on the media to look at the GBs. As we know, the broadcaster has been through a lot of changes.
I think we could add something here. Fancy a game of darts?
Let's do it.
Call me crazy.
Want to throw some darts?
Yeah, all right.
Getting arseholed and throwing bits of metal around has got to count as training somehow.
Fancy a game of darts?
Let's do it.
Strange. Just surrender.
What was that?
Shit for brains.
Did you hear that noise?
If not, you need to give up.
I still got it.
Come on, man.
Ah! This is unique. I'll keep looking.
Not some nipper fresh out of law school. Don't fuck with me.
Want to play some darts?
Yeah, all right, fuck it.
Ah, shit. Want to throw some darts?
You're on.
We've successfully trialed our first micro drone, and it's officially as cute as the dickens. I've decided to name it Sebastian.
Time to break into Titus.
And take away Nigel Cass's newest toy, Project Themis. Bagley, any idea where that name comes from?
Greek mythology. Themis was the goddess of divine justice. You know, the one with the sword.
Ooh, that is so Nigel fucking Cass.
See? School's useful for something besides social maladjustment. Find the schematics of the building, and I'll work out the location of the Themis project.
Don't let their drone get away. Block it.
Make it stop.
And search the area.
Sure, they're still in the area. Come out! Wherever you are! Could be anywhere right now.
We might go easy!
Out of lockdown on that vehicle.
Fuck! Have you looked at the Themis brief, ma'am?
Yes, I looked at it before I assigned you to the project. I am quite familiar with what it entails.
You must see the ethics...
Look round for anything named Themis.
I'm onto it.
Well, if I was hiding a top-secret, morally dubious drone project like Themis, I would put it in the secure vault on the lowest level. You will have to hack your way past some pretty serious security, however. The elevator that leads to the secure vault that houses Themis is locked down. You will have to access the bypass terminal to use it. You will require a spider bot.
Go on, Spidey. Go.
You'll be using Sebastian and the rest of the microdrones to bypass security. But first you'll have to get by that laser array. I suggest a spider bot and steady nerves.
I'm onto it.
Our job is not an easy one, but it is an important one. Right now, we devote countless hours to intelligence gathering, and still things slip through the cracks. We're doing our best, you tell me. We are, but our best isn't good enough.
That doesn't sound right.
But even we aren't perfect yet.
Yeah, they'll like that. That strikes a humble note.
We make errors in judgment. That's human nature, but we cannot afford errors. We are the last resort to protect the people. Project Themis will dispense justice and protection. It will use data to predict the patterns of crime and abuse. It will let us transcend the faults in our own nature.
Not bad. Yeah, they'll have questions, of course, which is fair. It's an extreme measure. And there is potential for abuse, but this is what London needs.
All right, Sebastian, this is what you and your friends have been training for. Time to crash the security grid for Daddy.
All right, let us see this Michael Jones in action.
That's the spirit. Should be pretty sick. This is taking too long, mate. Why don't you just shoot the damn door?
I can do this. Just give me a minute.
Time for tears. Meet Sebastian, another of our countless microdrone allies. All named Sebastian, of course. You can't iterate on perfection. cause. Destroy them, Sebastian, and for God's sake, be careful. Sebastian. Oh, right. You should be able to access the Themis project room now.
Let's ruin Nigel's fucking day.
London, once a beacon of civility, now a cesspool of lawlessness. It is clear that humanity can no longer police itself. Fortunately, we don't have to. Welcome to Project Themis. Albion has found a way to apply an existing system, LifeScore, a data aggregator of biometrics, personal information, to our new autonomous drones. These drones can identify, isolate, and terminate threats before they can do harm. They can go anywhere, see everything. They could kill a man alone in an alley or in a crowd of hundreds with perfect precision. Themis drones can do what humans have always struggled to. Act immediately and decisively.
Fuck me, I knew it! The LifeScore algorithm, my algorithm. I should have scrubbed it before I left.
What do you mean, Hamish? You know how Themis works.
No, fam. Well, yeah. This was years ago. We were developing a LifeScore algorithm for what Cass called a peacekeeping system. Supposed to identify vulnerable civilians, not target them.
Jesus.
So in theory, Themis could be programmed to target anyone based on any number of parameters.
Exactly. That's the way Cass thinks. Genius, but twisted. We have to stop this. And I know how. We delete the LifeScore data, and Themis is done.
Oh, fuck me. All right. It's done.
Yes, we'll have the award ceremony another time. Get out now. This may be entertaining. I've intercepted an audio transmission from Nigel Cass.
No, no more excuses. This is my city, and I will not have DedSec ruin my plans for it. Themis was poised to change London, the world. And this group of... And Hamish fucking Balaji? I want them all. They made you all look like fools. They walked calmly into the White Tower, and no one, not one of you, stopped them with all our vaunted security measures. So do any of you have anything to say?
Nothing. Well, everyone, and I mean everyone, in the organization will be re-vetted immediately. Someone help them, that's certain, and we will root them out. This time, we will get them all.
Well, that's about done it. Cass is going to steam about this for a while. No more life score, no more Themis. You did it.
It was a team effort. Big up to all of us. But we still have a lot more to do if we're going to finish off Cass for good. We can use some help.
Not much of a joiner, fam. Considering how my days at Albion ended. But I'll be keeping watch on them and Cass. Maybe feed you lots of intel.
And there's still the question of Zero Day. Remember them? Completely gutted DedSec 1.0.
Cass had a hand in that purge, Bagley, and in the bombings. So we'll gladly accept any help you can give us, Hamish. Cheers.
I'm not bragging, but I think I'm doing pretty damn good fighting with DedSec.
You wouldn't have been recruited if DedSec thought you'd be killed that easily.
Thank you, sir. I think.
The bagsman is like that. Bit of a prick, but dead useful. Just ignore him if he's vexing you.
In the last adventure of Detective Bagley and his occasionally helpful human sidekicks, we discovered that a billionaire tech mogul and a war profiteer both had secret plots to exploit human suffering and murder thousands. A shocking twist, I know. Speaking of the people we most suspect, Mary Kelly's slave trade is bound to be any day now, and we also just received a distress signal from a coffee shop of all places. Maybe the Wi-Fi's down or something.
Is that relevant, Bagley?
Yes, obviously there's more to it than that, but I knew I had to make a joke or you'd just tune it out. I've marked both leads on your optic.
This looks a little beer.
Nice. Thank you.
All right, another fine member of the crew. Welcome to DedSec.
Fuck yeah. Ready to help make a difference.
Fantastic.
Stormzy's accessing the server. What kind of show can he put on while he's hidden away?
Check one, check two. Yo, what's going on, people? It's Stormzy, it's The Problem, it's Big Mike, and we've got DedSec running interference. Yo, DedSec, yo, planet Earth, I want everybody watching this to spread the word. Sirs is here, and they're trying to shut us down. Everywhere you look, there's some jacked-up guards locking us up, murdering us, and if they can't do that, then they just take what they want from us. They make us poor, and then they beat us down to nothing so that we can't resist. And you know what? None of this is new. The powers that be, they've always been trying to keep us down. Same shit, different day. But me, I'm the one thing they fear most. I'm a black man with money. I've got shit to say, I've got the P to back it up, I've got tech, I've got fame, I've got fans, and I've got Ross Clark dead set ready to fight with me. No matter how hard they hit us, and I mean all of us, we've got to let our minds speak. And if anyone wants to stop us, if anyone tries to bring us to our knees, then all I can say is, let the rain fall on our enemies.
Let the rain fall on my enemies. All of my enemies. Yeah, let the rain fall on my enemies. On all of my enemies. Lord, let the rain fall on my enemies. Let it fall on my enemies.
All right, now cut the feed and let's get the fuck out of here.
Upload complete. Now Scarpa or they'll kill you for sure.
Dead sick. You will not believe what this looks like from the ground. The city is fucking popping tonight.
Negative. No visual of the suspect. Control. Let's put out an APW. We're getting nowhere here.
All right, dead set. What are we saying, bro? The track is trending global. Sirs thought they could shut us down. Aye, but you lot weren't having it, though. Aye, you lot smashed it, man. I'm still gassed from that show. I can't believe we did it. Flipping it, DedSec. We make a hell of a team.
Hey, you look like a fighter without a cause. Am I reading you right?
Hang on, are you dead sick? If you are, I need help with something.
We'll try, and that's more than most. What's going?
My friend disappeared last week. This happens sometimes. Usually it's no problem, but this time is different. Usually I get a text at least.
That's awful. I'm sorry.
Wait until you meet them. My friend has many character flaws. Sometimes I want to kill them. So if they piss off a real bad guy...
It's all right. We'll find them. Don't worry about it. Yeah, all right. That doesn't sound worrisome at all. Don't know where to start, but I'd say we should hurry. If we plan on finding them alive, that is.
Well, we could knock on every door in the city and see if they've got any abducted people on the premises. But it'd probably be smarter just to snoop around their last known location.
Yep, agreed. Send me those location deets.
Getting arsehole and throwing bits of metal around has got to count as training somehow.
A minute. Fancy a game? Thank you. Let's just move on.
We've got the dexterity of a fucking violinist, don't we?
Grant.
Who is this?
Thank you.
track.
How do you even begin to talk to someone like that?
Sorry, didn't see you there.
This again?
Now. Here, check the air skills. Fucked that up, didn't I?
I'm not the one for you. I know it, baby. I'm not the one for you.
Look at these lovely plants. Fancy a stroll, lads?
Getting arsehole and throwing bits of metal around has got to count as training somehow.
Do you want to play?
I love
Would you look at this place?
No. It's all good. Yeah, of course. You're in my spears, man.
The thing you're after is around here.
All right. Just get on with it.
Alert triggered. Come with me. Like
go get them.
I owe you one.
We have I'll hold back and come from here. Why are you doing this?
Steady yourself.
Fuck!
Oh, God!
Get your heads down!
Suspect reported in your area, potentially armed and hostile.
Moving inbound to hostile.
Go get them!
Immobilizing the suspect.
Go get them!
Required at our location. Over. Be advised, we are on the trail.
I need cover.
Anyone have visual? Anyone?
Control, we're heading back. Over.
Yeah, we can chat about.
Oh my God, I know.
You know, yeah, so you just.
Away.
Hey, I like that.
Very nice. Ooh, what do we have here?
Check in with Central.
Oh, hello there. Lovely. Now look at that. Yeah.
muck out of my inbox.
Get off.
You're in serious trouble now. Going in to check. Checking now.
That's the target. Should be hackable. Transfer complete.
Doctor, how you feeling? Are you
still here? Yeah,
it's just me. Really follow my finger.
Yes, again!
Great.
Yes! There is a God!
Right?
I don't want to know.
Good. Check your heart rate now. Thank you. Feeling better?
Keep up.
Keep up with your treatment.
Tell me about her bugs.
Actually, the strangest thing about her is that she's not weighed down by old soup cans at the bottom of the Thames. She's a load of dodgy gambling debts and she's refusing financial help from a rich friend.
I've never known a degenerate like that to turn down free money. Something's up.
Look at you keeping up. Maybe this friend can help explain our prospect's unusual behaviour.
Good idea. Bagley, get me a face-to-face.
it out and find them.
Are you sure you can still throw straight?
Let's chuck some darts.
Safe, bro. Let's play.
Did you see that?
I am the king of fucking darts, aren't I? Fuck yes.
By the government to circulate fake news and misinformation. So how did we get here? Where did it all go wrong? How can we tell when a national leader is a state propaganda? Our experts speak on conditions of anonymity for their own safety. Here's disinformation and media expert Charles, who's seen free broadcasters built up by journalists and torn down by demagogues all over the world.
So before the media fragmented, there was this voice of authority that was trusted and worthy of trust. Then what we ended up with is a really commercial model where whether you're talking about an app on a smart device or whether you're talking about a broadcaster, the most important thing to keep you in that environment for the long term. Situation where nobody trusted anything and nobody believed anything at all. And that is the perfect environment for an authoritarian voice to come in and say, no way, we are the truth. So the ground for this environment really got created when we had so many authoritarian politicians everywhere. And anything that threatened them or they disagreed with, they would call it disinformation. That's disinformation. That's fake news. And again, we got in a situation where nobody...
See? Isn't that much better?
I'm glad we understand each other.
Is where's all the money coming and I'm listening. They can spend lavish amounts on these bloody checkpoints.
Seriously, no, hold on.
Sure.
Yeah, okay.
It's the same.
Listen.
Tour of Waterloo Station. It was fine. You know, mostly for my mum and all that. They told me this one story that's a crack.
This needs to be reported.
This bus tycoon in Victoria told me nothing about it on the private train car.
When
some
nuts
rushed through the glass ceiling and stabbed him to death.
On the right-hand side.
Right,
when you walk in.
There were details that I've forgotten.
Fucked that up, didn't I? Shite in the bucket. Ah, fuck.
Oh, it was the Dutch bonus. I mean, literally, the Dutch bonus got so large.
Fucked that up, didn't I? Ah, fuck. Ah, shite in the bucket. Didn't I? Fucked that up, didn't I?
Can you believe?
Ah, fuck. Ah, shite in the bucket. Do you need help? What can I do?
This is about my friend, isn't it? Oh, God. She's okay, right?
She's in way over her head.
I'm listening.
She's destroying her life with this stupid gambling. I tried to help her get out of debt, but no. Now she's off to meet those Clan Kelly thugs. They're going to kill her.
That's terrible. Can't promise nothing, but we'll have a poke around.
I've tracked our naughty little gambler to a location that's crawling with Clan Kelly goons.
Let's get nosy then. Through at the gym. Getting fat.
Keep it up!
Not bad. That made my knee come. Fucker's showing off now.
Violent crime anymore anyway. You know, you can just start after death without even starting a gang war.
We do have to ask, exactly what does the Prime Minister make of all this? Let's ask him. Is there anyone else I can talk to?
Yes, of course. There's a shady cabal of vested interest in controlling and prop him up in power.
Great, I'll have a chat with them then.
Oh, Andy, remember when you could get away with prank calls without people coming round to your house to beat the shit out of you?
Oh, happy times.
You're listening to The Bar.
Did you think the Prime Minister will ever come back?
I don't think we've ever had a Prime Minister.
Well, that's a much more reassuring way of looking at things. What have we become? Alice, we live in the state of our politics. We're supposed to have the mother of parliaments. Well, this is one mother that has emphatically abandoned her kids in the woods to be brought up by wolves. And let me tell you, that never works out like it does in the stories. Wolves are bad parents. Unless you're a wolf, in which case they can do a job pretty well as a wolf. Do not give your children to wolves. And do we actually own anything as a country now? Is there anything we haven't flogged off for profit? I think we've basically just become a homeopathic Britain. Diluted and diluted until there's barely a trace of the original Britain left. But some quackish lunatics insist it actually works better that way. It's total bullshit. Is there anything left? A new on the bug this week. A new feature. The bug-off feature. The person who has most irritated us in Britain this week, we're going to tell to bug-off. And to get things going, I'm going to nominate Big Nigel. Nigel Cass. Look, this is Britain. History tells us this place is a bastion of freedom. I'm just not sure that that kind of freedom should involve Big Nigel expressing his freedom to run a private army. I guess, historically, there is a precedent. The East India Company That was a trading hammer with 250,000 soldiers, which is a lot for a company. The Bug PLC has Alice with a water pistol, but crucially, compared with Albion, the East India Company didn't operate its 250,000 strong army in London. It did it a long way away, out of sight, out of mind.
Our gambler is nearby. I suppose they might make it out on their own, but going off the number of goons here, I don't like the odds. Get to her quickly. That's her. Get her out of here.
Go get them! Go get them! Go get them! Go get them!
I got him! Ah, no! Ah, ah!
Thank you.
yes, yes. Well done. Let's make sure they're all right.
They're listening to everything. But don't worry, we're not going to say anything bad about a massive, unaccounted for spy organization that uses its powers to stifle dissent and shut down free speech. Instead, we're going to look at how SIRS became so powerful. And as usual, we'll keep everyone's names and locations secret so SIRS doesn't come looking for them. Ian was a veteran political writer and podcaster back in the days of pre-crisis Britain.
It's the world we're living in now, fascist. Well, this is what fascism is. It's the complete, total control of the individual. The desire to basically say to the individual, nothing in your life matters. On an individual basis, you are now part of the whole, part of the nation. And the only meaning that you will find in life is to become part of the nation. What is the nation? The nation doesn't mean anything, right? The nation is basically just...
Y'all right there?
Fool! I was running the business. I was in charge before you stuck in your nose.
Okay.
Fine. I wasn't totally in charge. I lost some power, but I had faith the con would work.
What do you mean?
Let me break it down for you. I built up massive debt to get them to bring me in, so I plant a virus to thief all their crypto. Boom. But it brought a little more rage than I expected. I was underprepared.
Well, that much is obvious.
Stroke of genius. You sneak in and upload the virus. Help a girl out. I'll give you 10%.
I'm on it.
So she was actually gambling with her own life. Talk about raising the stakes.
We ought to help her out. Might convince her to join.
I found the Kelly lieutenant who should make a great target for the crypto-draining virus. I'll send you their details now.
Charles is an expert in the dark arts of surveillance who worked to set up democratic media in post-communist states. How did it go so wrong in Britain?
You know, we're looking at all the wrong things when we look at Britain's crisis. There's a lot of concentration on data and how that's been used and manipulated. And what we haven't looked at is the power structures and the profit that lies behind this. For example, if we examine what actually happened, you know, there's a company that's really very interested in selling passports and making it easy to provide visas for investment and so on. And historically, throughout the world, they've been working with this big data manipulation company
to overthrow
governments. And then suddenly, all the chickens came home to roost. Nobody could find any receipts for what was paid for. Nobody could figure out how things were done. Everybody had a feeling that something really stunk, and they couldn't figure it out. And yet, it was standing there in their face the whole time. There's a couple of different ways that we got where it is that we are. I mean, one, you have a lot of smaller organizations, smaller power groups, companies as well, who are bending things just a little. Oh, we'll compromise a little bit. We'll bend the rules a little bit and try to achieve what it is that we are.
Are you fucking kidding me?
The target for that crypto stealing virus is around here.
Grand! Good spot for some art.
Well done.
Now that'll do just fine.
That's him there. Get ready with the virus upload.
What the fuck?
Some error is blocking my access.
I'll call it in. Hold it.
Upload complete. Now Scarpa or they'll kill you for sure. Virus install complete.
She'll be pleased about that. We ought to share the good news with her. Took care of that thing for you.
Big up yourself. You finessed that. Crypto's funneling straight into my wallet. Gonna buy a hot tub. Maybe we can make this a side thing.
You know, DedSec's looking for fighters. And you seem to have some fight in you. How about letting it out?
Count me in.
Who's this?
Bagley here. How did everything go earlier?
Excellent, love. May even have a new recruit. Ready?
There's a mysteriously large number of Kelly goons hanging around this derelict gas plant. You'd think at least one of them would pick up a broom.
Where there's smoke, there's fire. Let's find our mouse nibbling at the cheese.
I doubt the Kellys trust her up like that to get their Cub Scout knot-tying badges. Her optic sync log suggests that this is our thief.
She's most likely to be the source of the money leak, but let's still be cautious. This makes me miss the way things were.
Search the area. remains undetected.
Heads up!
She won't forget that. You did all right, I suppose.
Thank you. I was about to get the Clan Kelly P-45. No gold, just lead. But I'm done with all of it. Organised crime, London.
Before you skip town, mind telling us how you pulled it off? We could carry on your work.
Sure. Clan Kelly's laundering their dirty money into cryptocurrency. A lot of it.
Do go on.
I set up a keylogger to capture the passwords I needed to hijack the operation. Divert all the cash out of their crypto wallets.
Cracking. Thank you, dear. We'll bleed them dry for you.
The accountant's keylogger with the Kelly account password is at the spine. Clever nickname. You might need a spider bot when you get there.
Then let's pop by and see what we can find. Let's do some arts and crafts. much better.
I hope you're not doing anything important. You've been activated.
Good to go.
Obvious Clan Kelly Shell Company is an office here. The keylogger will be in there, along with a bunch of twitchy heavies with bugger all to do all day.
So you wouldn't advise a frontal assault?
I mean, I would for my own personal amusement, but I doubt you'd find being dead nearly as much fun. Plus, there is an extensive network of grids that a spiderbot could navigate.
All right, let's look around.
Oh! pretty much what I expected. This wall is so boring. Let's change it. Got the key. Now for the data. Sweet. Got all the passwords. Let's get out of here.
That thing is mental.
Looks like the money's being kept in air-gapped servers at the Bank of England. Only way to access it is in person.
Does that mean we get to literally rob the Bank of England?
Correct. If you're going to rob a bank, you might as well rob a heavily fortified national treasury. That's what I always say. At least it is now.
We don't have any choice when it comes to the Optic. Yes, it's convenient and mandatory, but everybody's forgotten what it really means. Here...
Once we access the money, I'll need to pass it through some phone accounts so they can't trace it. After that, you can do what you like. Give it to the victims, donate it to charity, dump it all in a big bath and roll around in it going tra-la-la-la-la.
First one, please, Bugs. You know, the thought of robbing the Bank of England makes me feel a bit guilty, but also kinda excited.
The one in uniform.
Get your fucking hands off!
Fucking fuck! You're only making it worse for yourself.
Definitely not a welcoming vibe here. We reach the server room box.
You can access the air-gapped servers through one of those terminals.
You hear that? Surrender!
Ah, yet another piece.
stop this!
Sneaky little rat.
Let's find this one!
Couldn't have gone far.
We will find you!
I'm in. Oh shit, and they know it. We're ready for trouble.
Watch the perimeter.
Moving in.
The transfer is underway. But I need more time. Nearly there. Try to survive a bit longer.
That's it! You're already dead.
Transfer complete.
Bossy, bossy. Let's hurry up. Come out of here.
You're in trouble now.
Managed to divert some of those funds to our coffers. Never know when it might come in handy.
Gosh, that was fucking exciting.
Yes, your adrenaline was spiking worse than a skydiving cokehead. I believe that's what they call a gambler's rush.
I don't know about that part, but the buzz me I get right now, knowing we'll help some people and the Kellys I get nothing, hey, feels pretty damn good.
Making you talk, and now Germans all have that American accent, where it's all like, oh, welcome to the party, we're having a really nice time. He's not friendly, a German. Let him stay.
Well, that's all today.
It's not as bad as it seems.